altogether strange how we never discovered an answer. In Mr. H.G. Wells' story of the men who invaded the moon, he describes a conversation between the travelers and the Grand Lunar. The Grand Lunar asked them many questions about the Earth, which they were unable to answer. What? He explains. Knowing so little of the Earth, do you attempt to explore the moon? We men know little enough of ourselves. It would have been no cause to astonishment had we been unable to define God. Men lost themselves for ages in guesswork. They looked round about. They saw how grandly a million worlds revolved. They noticed exquisitely the mighty forces of the earth are governed, the majesty, the infinite wonders of all things, the high peaks of the mountains, the depths of the canyons, the mighty river that works and cuts her way through rock and earth, emptying into an immense ocean. Then they made their guess. God is power, they said. God is power. Then, peering a little more deeply into the heart of things, they saw that all these terrific forces are not only controlled, but hold us unto high ends. From microscopic to giant planets light years away, all were ordered down to the last detail. All things working. They are working together. They are working together for good. And thereupon, men make their second guess. God is wisdom, they said. God is wisdom. Then, observing things still more closely, they begin to see the great ethical principles underlying the laws of the universe. In the long run, evil suffers. In the long run, right is rewarded. God is justice, they said. God is justice. And so men made their guesses, and as they guessed, they built, they erected temples. Now to the God of power. Then to the God of wisdom. And again to the God of justice. They had yet to learn that they were worshiping the part and not the whole. They were worshiping the rays and not the light itself. Then Jesus, this powerful, wise, just God, came as a mortal man. And men understood by his works and his deeds, by his life and his death, he revealed the whole truth. God is power, wisdom, and justice. But he is more. In the European churchyard, there stands a monument erected by a poet to his wife. It bears the inscription, "She was." But words are wanting to say what? Think what a wife should be, and she is that. God is. God is what? He is. But words are wanting to say what? Think what a God should be, and he is that. Jesus, though in this age-long blank, not in a cold language, but in warm life. Many attempts have been made to translate his definitions between the terms of life into the terms of language. Only once had those attempts been approximately successful. The words perforated on the bookmarker represent the best given answer that human speech has ever given to the question. God is. God is what? God is love. Amen.
Dictionary defines a pledge as a binding promise or agreement to do or forbear. Each time we recite the pledge, we often forget that we are truly making a vow. We are promising our devotion to our country no matter what. Throughout the schools of our nation, we teach our youth to memorize this oath, often forgetting to teach them why they ought to learn it. In Numbers chapter 30, verse 2, the Bible states, "If a man vow a vow unto the Lord, or swear an oath to bind his soul with a bond, he shall not break his word. He shall do according to all that proceedeth out of his mouth." Also, Ecclesiastes, a book written by Solomon, the wisest man to ever live, reiterates this in the 5th verse of chapter 5. "Better is it that thou shouldest not vow, than that thou shouldest vow and not pay." The Bible clearly cautions us, but oh, how often we reject this counsel. As an American, it is an honor to wake up each morning and say that I pledge my allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. That's why we have a flag, so citizens all across America can show their loyalty to this nation and daily reflect on the principles that have made America the greatest country on earth. The flag that we pledge to nearly every day cost a great price that we often overlook. Countless numbers of men and women have given their lives so that Star-Spangled Banner can wave high for all to see. As we pass courthouses, hospitals, fire and police stations, churches and schools, we see it there, reminding us of what America once was and what it has the potential to become. Millions of hours over the course of many decades have been spent in making this country the place that we know and love and call our home. Can you imagine the excitement on George Washington's face when he beheld the first American flag in 1776? What joy must have flooded his soul. The American flag became the symbol of this blossoming republic and signifies so many important values. The red stripes symbolize hardiness and valor. The white stripes stand for purity and innocence, while the blue represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice. These ethics should be visible in the life of every American. Take, for instance, Mike Christian, who was a Vietnam prisoner of war. He and many other prisoners, clothed in ragged blue Vietnamese pajamas and rubber sandals, were crowded together with nowhere to lay their heads but on a cold concrete slab. Mike had fashioned a bamboo needle and found some scraps of red and white cloth. So he began to stitch an American flag to the inside of his shirt. Each day, the prisoners would hang up Mike's shirt and recite the Pledge of Allegiance. That is, until the Vietnamese found the shirt. Upon this discovery, they immediately removed both Mike and his shirt from the cell. For hours, they brutally beat and tortured Mike. Then finally, opened the cell door and threw him back inside. That night, in the corner of the room, beneath the bare light bulb, sat Mike Christian. Although his eyes were nearly swollen shut and his hands bruised and feeble, in his grasp was his bamboo needle. Holding another shirt and some more pieces of red and white cloth, Mike sewed another American flag. Pledging to the flag may not seem to us as the most important thing in our lives, but to those men in that grim prison cell, they felt honored to pledge their lives to America and to its flag. Over the years, there has been a huge decline in respect for the flag. Statistics show that reverence for the flag began to decrease during the Civil War era, and have since then gone down at a faster rate than ever before. In today's society, respect, reverence, and honor are words not often used or portrayed. Something must change, or America is headed for destruction. As Americans, we must decide that we want America. One note to start a song, one seed to grow a tree, one flame to start a fire, one drop to make a ripple, and one person to change the world.
Yes.
Your voice, though little may it be, can echo throughout the hearts and minds of others. Each voice matters, each stand makes a difference, and each pledge can influence another. America, this great and mighty nation, is worth my allegiance. It is worth your allegiance. So the next time you say those words, will you mean them? Will you be sincere? Will you earnestly say them with all of your heart? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Will you join me and take the pledge?
Yeah.